Well, the one thing I love about Walker Buehler and the reason why he's so nasty is the command and the rise of his fastball. Anywhere from 95 to 98 miles an hour. It reminds me a lot of Jacob deGrom. He gets a ton of swings, swing and misses at the top of the zone, which sets up everything else for his breaking ball and his slider to get swing and misses down in the zone.
Yeah, to me, it reminds me of another Met, Dwight Gooden, very much like deGrom, who threw a very north and south. He threw the fastball up top at 96 to 98, and then he had the overhand curveball. There's no surprise the league is only hitting 143 off his fastball, Poppy.
Yeah, I like I say, you know, that high racing fastball is what everybody dream of.
Right.
As a hitter, let's go to the box right here. As a hitter, everything you see or hear look good, but it's hard to get. 97 up here, folks, you dream about hitting that, but it's hard to get there. That's the impossible dream for a hitter right there. Because this fastball racing right here, especially 95 plus, 97, the way guys are throwing right now, it's hard to get on top of it. We practice, you guys know that we practice, try to get on top of the ball. We practice, but not at that level right there. We're trying to get it on top of the ball, the strike zone down here. But once he go up here a couple of inches higher, it's hard to match that right
But
up
your
there.
Eyes are above the baseball, so it looks like enticing.
It looks great.
You look like you can get on top of it. But for me, especially setting up the secondary pitches, once he sees that you're attacking that up pitch, now he can go down and into Big Poppy and make you swing over the top of it. So now that puts another variable in your mind of what you have to attack, and it puts the hitter on the heels, and it puts you guys guessing, and that's why he gets a lot of swing and misses.
And I've watched a few of his starts, too. He reminded me of a young Justin Verlander.
Right.
He could consistently throw the ball up to 100 miles an hour.
I mean, up here.
Great breaking stuff. He has a slider and a breaking ball. That's what makes him great. With this stuff is so great, he can get you out with two pitches.
Right.
Bottom line is, he has a mentality. He's laid back. You can tell he's never phased. But the bottom line is, he is the future ace of the Dodgers.
He's got a little swagger.
He's got a lot of swagger.
Yeah.
And this guy knows how to go up and down the zone like a young Verlander. It's a very unfair bet for right-handers. Good luck, right-handers, I think, is all up to left-handers when you face Walker Buehler.
So, Frank, as you're driving to the park and you're facing Justin Verlander, tell me what your thought process is. How do you attack him in your four bats?
My whole career, I always had the same approach. But against Justin Verlander, after the second time I faced him, I said, from now on, I'm going to look down in the zone for the fastball. And that's the only chance I got against him. I kept my eye level down here the entire time. Anything up here, I never would offer at it because he would pound me in hard. But the only thing for a strike inside would be down. So one or two pitches a game, I was hoping to get that pitch the entire time against Justin Verlander.
And what part of the field were you trying to hit it when you got your fastball down?
Well, Justin, I was trying to hit, for the first time, trying to hit over the shortstop's head because the breaking ball is so great, you got to choose your poison when a guy's this dominant, and that's what you have with Walker Buehler. You got to look down in the zone and try to split the plate and try to make sure, as a right-hander, trying to look over the shortstop, or if you want to zone him out and go opposite field, I will go opposite field also because this guy can strike you out with the best of them. Bottom line, you're going to get one or two pitches of bat that you can handle.
Yeah.
As a hitter, you know, one thing that I used to do, guys, most of the young hitter coming into coming out of the system into the big league, I always like to talk to them about trying to stay away from this pitch up here. This pitch right here, especially when you don't have the experience, when you haven't played at this level, the big league level, you guys know that, D-Train. You guys know how to control more the strike zone. You guys know what you guys are doing with the strike zone. It's, as a hitter, it's the same thing. You know, you start working on what part of the zone you control, what part of the zone you can drive the ball, and then you work on the rest of it, right? Mm-hmm. So I always used to talk about this pitch right here, 97 right here. It looked great, looked perfect. You look like you are on top of it, but the problem is try to get on top of that pitch. We practice, use the top hand, try to go on top of the ball, but not at this pitch right here. When you talk about use your top hand, get on top of the ball, we're talking about the fastball right here, the pitch is down here. Once you go above that level right there, it's trouble for any hitter.
That's the one I got you on. That's the one level I got you on. He's absolutely right because I went a couple levels down, and it's a double off the wall. But that's part of the game. So I agree 1,000%. It's definitely ball length.
So, Poppy, I just have one question. So tell me how you attack this hitter, how Big Poppy used to attack the ball. So from top to down, top hand. Now show me the modern-day hitter, the young kids. How are they swinging now?
Launch angle.
Good luck with that approach.
Yeah.
Against the Walker Buehler.
Show me your swing going from top to bottom, how you came up swinging. Boom. Now show me the modern day swing, how these young kids are going after it. And you see this angle right here? When you're Walker Buehler and you're throwing 96 up here, it is impossible for you two to collide. Therefore, that's why 143 batting average against a fastball. Mm-hmm. And that's why this guy's quickly becoming one of the best, if not the best pitcher for the Dodgers.
Yeah.